going to start it. So first of all, what is computational mathematics? It's just about the mathematics performed by a computer, okay? It's computational, derived from computer, and mathematics is, of course, it's just a theory and game of numbers. It referred to the use of computer for mathematics itself. So why do I need computer to do mathematics? I can do it. I can do plus, minus, multiply, divide. You know, I can do it.
Can yes, you? That's correct.
Yeah, that's right. But okay, if I give you a ball and ask you to please calculate its area, and I give you the formula and the value, you can. Okay, this is simple mathematics. But what about those objects which we cannot see? Okay, for example, I have, for example, this object. This is some meteorite in the space or some planet. You cannot go there and measure the mass or measure the, you know, area of the stone. So you need some approximation to calculate the area. So there are, for example, if I ask you to please do a large calculation for me, the calculation is so long that it is written on 4 pages. So it would not be possible for you to do it. Maybe if you're so good in mathematics, you can do it, but you will take a lot of time to do it, okay? So there are some calculations which are beyond human capabilities and normal human beings cannot do it. That is why we ask our computer systems to do those mathematics for us. That is, in this course, we are going to study about that computational mathematics. Okay, this includes use of computers for mathematics computation, the study of which can or cannot be computerized in mathematics. Okay, we are going to learn. Okay, what is an algorithm? Guma, what is an algorithm? Bitte, do you know what is an algorithm?
Yes, it's more like a flow of task, how a task should flow.
Very good. Very good. Well done. It's actually a flow of task. You tell your system how to do a specific task. Okay. So if I make an algorithm of adding two numbers and I tell my computer, you can add these two numbers if you follow these processes by sequence. So what should be the properties of a desirable algorithm, a perfect algorithm or an ideal algorithm?
It should be an error-free.
Oh yes, error-free, exactly. That is called the accuracy. There is no chance of error. Okay, the efficiency. It should do the multiplication or mathematical manipulation fast, in no time, okay? Reliability and stability. It should be reliable, okay? If I made an algorithm and it can add any numbers which are 2 digits, okay? Like 20, 99, 33. 2 digits number, and it is not valid for the numbers which are 3 digits. So my algorithm is not working. It is not reliable. It is not stable because it can work for specific numbers and cannot work for other numbers. Okay. So it's not reliable.
Yes.
So these are the three properties of an desirable algorithm. It's accurate, it's efficient, and it's reliable. Okay, types of math used in computer science. Okay, I'm going computer science, I must know why, ma'am. Why are you teaching me mathematics? Like I'm not doing degree in mathematics, but you are teaching me a course. So now we are going to learn where our mathematics is used in computer sciences. Okay, 5 types of math is used in computer sciences. First is binary mathematics. You know what is binary? Binary means 2. Gumam, can you hear me, beta?
Yes, miss, I can hear you.
Okay, so binary mathematics is actually, it is mathematics of 2 numbers, 0 and 1. All the calculations, all the numbers are represented in 0 and 1. And we are going to learn how. Second is algebra. Of course, algebra is some equations involving and different methods. Third is statistics. Yes. Statistics is very, very, very important part of any economy, of any group, okay? If there are 10 students in your class, you must know, okay, there are how many students, 10 students, of which age, of which gender, how many students score good, how many students do not score good. All are these known by statistics. Statistics is just information in the form of numbers, okay? And another is calculus. Calculus is actually advanced form of mathematics. And fifth is discrete math. Discrete math is actually works with the different theorems. why we need mathematics in computing. Mathematics is a fundamental intellectual tool in computing, but computing is also increasingly used as a key component in mathematical problem solving. Okay, where are we going to use mathematics and why? Discrete mathematics in the foundation of computer sciences. Like we read number theory, logic notation, cell theory, combinatory, graph theory, probability, Boolean algebra. These are all used in logic gates, relational algebra.
Miss, what's Boolean algebra?
Boolean algebra is algebra of binary numbers. We are going to learn it in coming slides. Okay.
All right, miss.
Okay. Relational algebra is used in data. These are all examples where which form of mathematics is used in which branch of computer sciences. In case you need other example, number theory has multiple applications in cryptography and cryptanalysis. Mathematics teaches the uses of algorithm. Okay. Mathematics helps us to use an algorithm and implement it. And mathematics provide the analytical skills required in computer sciences. Okay, how mathematics help us to build analytical skills? Okay, this is an image. Gumam beta, can you tell me which place is this? Have you ever seen this before?
Dubai. Yes, I've been there, and it's Burj Khalifa.
Yes, very good. This is Burj Khalifa. Okay, so why it is famous?
Is it the most advanced and the tallest building, you can say?
Yes, it's the tallest building. And how it's made? There are many thousands and millions of calculations behind the creation of this Burj Khalifa. Okay, and how its foundation is laid, there are numerous mathematical calculations that okay, this part has to be placed at this angle. Okay, how many concrete is used, how many other cement is used, how many the metallic rods are used in it. Everything is calculated by mathematics. Even the maps designed for Burj Khalifa are full of mathematics. These are all mathematics. So see, this is an amazing building, Burj Khalifa. All the world knows it. And without mathematics, it couldn't have been here. So you see, mathematics is important. Okay, important terms to be used in mathematics. There is no need to memorize it. You just have to go through it. And in coming slides, we are going to learn them. First is variables, right. Constants, algebra, Boolean algebra, bits, bytes, decimals, and binary. Okay, these are few terms, hexadecimal. Okay, what is variable? Okay, we are going to learn these one by one. Okay. Variable is a quantity that may change within a context of a mathematical problem or experiment. Okay, so there is a quantity which can be changed according to circumstances, according to time. That quantity is called variable because it varies. Typically, we use a single letter to represent a variable. The letter X, Y, and Z are common generic symbol for a variable. Here you can see an equation. 10 is equal to 2X. Okay.
Anything left on the left side of equal is called variable, right?
No. Variable can be at any side of the equation. It's just something whose value is unknown. Okay, see, this 10 is constant. This 2 is coefficient of x. And x is a variable because we don't know the value of x. How can we find this value of x? Do you have any idea?
We bring it to the left side of the equal.
Yes.
If we move 10 to the right, it will be negative 10.
Oh, no, Guma. See, the 2 is being multiplied with the x. Okay.
Yes. Oh, yes.
So x should be a number.
It will be division. If we move it.
X should be a number that if we multiplied that number with 2, we get the answer 10. So 10. Which is the number we multiplied by 2 and get the answer 10?
We can go by 5.
5. Very good. So x here, the value of x is 5. Okay. Do you get it?
Yes, miss.
Okay, good. So now we are going to learn about constants. What is a constant? Okay. Constant is something which do not change. Okay. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in any algebraic expression or equation, if any term is not changing, that is called constant. For example, in this example, 10 is fixed. The value of 10 is 10. It is not possible that I said the value of 10 is 6. Okay, it would be wrong. So this 10, it has a specific constant value. So this is my constant. Okay. See here, this is an equation. Y is equal to 7x plus 8. So see, the y and x are variable because we don't know the value of y and x. 8 is constant, plus is an operator, and 7. Any constant multiplied with any variable is called the coefficient of that variable. Okay. This is the term used for any constant multiplied with any variable. Here we have another example. 4 is coefficient, x is variable because we don't know the value. This is an operator, mathematical operator. This is constant and this is constant. Did you get it?
Yes.
Okay, very good. If you have any question, you can ask me at any time, okay? So the thing you asked before, it is about Boolean algebra. What is Boolean algebra? It is a branch of mathematics that deals with operation on logical values with binary variable. Okay, we are going to learn how. What are binary variable? The Boolean variable are represented as binary number to represent the truth. For example, 1 is true and 0 is false. Only two numbers are used in Boolean algebra. In normal or elementary algebra, there are many numbers from 0 to 9, and in any order, there are numerous operations. Okay? But in Boolean algebra, we just have two numbers, 1 and 0, and all other numbers are not, we cannot use any other number, okay? 3, 4, 5, we cannot use.
Yes, Miss, I can hear.
Okay, in Boolean algebra, 1 plus 1 is not equal to 2. How? Okay. First we need to see that in binary language, how do we write? 2 raised to power 0 is 1, 2 raised to power 1 is 2, 2 raised to power 2 is 4, 2 raised to power 3 is 8, and 2 raised to power 3 means 2 is multiplied by 2 3 times, okay? 2 is multiplied by itself by 4 times, 2 is multiplied by itself 5 times, okay? You can do it on your calculator as well. This term at the most left is called most significant bit, MSB. And this term at the rightmost is called LSB, least significant bit. Okay, I have a number, as I told you, that the only numbers 0 and 1 can be used. I have a number 17. How can I change this decimal? This is a decimal. This we call these number decimal numbers. How can we change the decimal number into binary? Divided by 2. Okay, 2 8s are 16. And what is left? 1. Okay, 2 8s are 16 and 1 is remainder. Are you getting me? Okay, then 2 4s are 8. And what is the remainder? It is completely divided. So remainder is?
0.
0, okay. And then 2 4s are 8. Remainder is?
0.
Okay, 2 2s are 4. Remainder is 0. And 2 1s are 2, okay? So now we get 1, which is less than 2. So we stop our division here and calculate from here. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1.
This we always come from the bottom?
Yes, yes, from the bottom. It's always come from the bottom. So 1001 is the binary code of decimal. Okay, how can we check which number is it? Okay, Gumam, remember 10001. Okay, okay.
Yes.
See here, 10001. So the zero placed at any number is not calculated. So we have 1, it means this bit is on, and we have 1 here, which means this bit is on. The between three numbers are 0. Are you getting me?
Yes.
I'm checking that if 10001 is 17 or not. So these bits are off. We have 0 here. So we are not going to count these. We are just counting this and this. So 16 plus 1 is?
17.
Okay, do you get it? Okay, Gumam, do you have a pencil or pen and a writing pad?
No, I can take it now. So.
Yeah, please, can you get it, please?
Divide the
Yes.
2 into 7, so we get 14. So remainder is 1.
Okay, the remainder is 1. Very good. And now divide 14 by 2.
It's 7 now.
Very good. Now divide 7 by 2. We did it by LCM method. You can do it as well.
The remainder is 6.
Did you divide 14 with 7? No. 6 and...
No, I didn't divide 14.
You divide A7.
Yes, I did 7.
Okay, 7. So 2, 3 times 6. 3 and you get remainder 1.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you spell
yes,
little bit assignment? Okay, sure. No problem. Okay, sorry for inconvenience. I thought you were at home.
No, miss. I'm sorry for that.
No problem, beta. Okay, so we were... Okay, so this is another example. How this is 65 and we have to find the binary coded decimal. So we have 65, we divide it to 3 times 6 and to 2 times 4, 32, 2 times 64, and we got 1 as reminder. Then we divide 32 by 2 and we get 16 and remainder is 0. Then we divide until we get 0 or 1. So this is here. So this is our code 1000001. So this is binary decimal code for 65. Okay. So here are yes. all the numbers of binary. These are called binary coded decimal. Okay. So binary numbers are decimal numbers and binary numbers are the code for decimal number. For 1, we write 1. For 0, we write 0. For 2, we write 10. For 3, we write 11. For 4, we write 100. 5, 101. 6, 110. 7, 111. 8, 1000. 9, 1001. 10, 1010. How can you check if they are right or not? Take an example of 8, okay? 1000. Here. 8, 1000. So this bit is on only, other are off. So what is the answer? 8. Okay. So you can check other numbers as well if you want to. For 10, we have 1010. Okay. For 10, we have 1010. So only this bit and this bit is on. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So 8 plus 2 is 10.
Yeah.
Okay. So what if I am given with this binary numbers? And I have to convert, I have to check what decimal number its corresponding is. So, okay, I can convert binary to decimal. Here we have, I had converted decimal to binary. Okay. Now I'm converting binary to decimal. Okay. So start from this, multiply, try multiplying it from 2 raised to power 0. Multiply the first number with 2 raised to power 0. Second, multiply it with 2 raised to power 1. Third, multiply it with 2 raised to power 2. Fourth, multiply it with 2 raised to power 3. Okay, see, 1011. Okay, we read it from least significant bit. Okay, we read 1011, not 1101. Okay,
so we always go from left to right.
Yeah, if you want to go from other side, you have to mention that I am reading from LSB or MSB. If you want to read from left to right, you should mention that I am starting from most significant bit. Okay.
Most significant.
Yeah. Here we are starting from least significant bit. So I multiplied the least significant bit 1 with 2 raised to power 0, the 0 with 2 raised to power 1, 1 with 2 raised to power 2, and the last one, the most significant bit with 2 raised to power 3. See, 1 multiplied by 8 and added all those. 1 multiplied by 4 plus 0 multiplied by 2 plus 1 multiplied by 1. 8 ones are 8. 4 ones are 4. 0 times 2 is
0. 0.
1 into 1, 1. Add these and all these are 8 plus 4 plus 1 is 13. So this was the code of 13. Okay. Okay, Gumam?
Yes.
So we can do it. We can practice it. and I'm going to send you a few examples to solve, and hopefully you can do it with ease. Otherwise, if you can't, you can tell me and ask me anytime. Okay, how two binary numbers are added? As we discussed, 1 plus 1 is not equal to 2 in binary numbers. The answer can only be in 0 or 1. So see, this is the result. If we add two numbers, 0 plus 0, the result is 0, the carry is 0.
Zero.
If we add 0 plus 1, the result is 0 plus 1, 1.
One.
The carry is 0.
Zero.
1 plus 0 is result is 1 and carry is 0. And 1 plus 1 is result is 0 and carry is 1. Okay? This is important.
Yes.
If you add 1 plus 1, we write 0 and we carry 1. Okay, see here. We are going to add 85 and 181. The code for 85 is 1010101. Okay, you can check it. And code for 181 is 10110101. Okay?
Yes.
So we add 1 from least significant bit. We add 1 plus 1. Addition, result is 0. And 1 is carry. Okay?
Yes.
So 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1.
Carry is 0.
Good. 1 plus 1 is?
0.
0 and 1 is carry. Okay? So 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is again 0 and 1 carry. And this 1 plus this 1 is 0 and 1 carry. And again this 1 plus this 1. 0 and 1 carry and 1, 1, 0 and 1 carry. So 1 is here. Okay?
Yes.
So does it help? Did you understand it?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay, okay, okay. We are going to do practice to get it clear. Okay? So if you can see, we got this. This is actually the binary code of 266. Let's add it here. 5 plus 1, 6. 8 plus 8, 16. 6 here, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 2. So 266. So you can check from both. All those these two answers are similar. Actually same, not similar, same. Okay? So how can we subtract it? Subtraction is easy. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. So I'm taking 1 carry here. We cannot... One, I take carry here. I take a carry from here. So here we have zero. And here we have one. One minus one. Do you get me, Vita?
Yes, miss.
Okay, okay. So as you do not have paper or pencil. So you can do it later on it. Okay. The subtraction is done. Okay, no problem. The subtraction is done similarly the way we do the addition, okay? For multiplication, you know, 0 into 0 is?
0 always.
0 into 1 is? 0. 1 into 0 is 0 and 1 into 1 is? 1. So this is very easy. You can do the multiplication. 1 into 1 is 1. You know how to do multiplication?
Yes, yes.
Okay, 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 0 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1. We multiply 1 with all those numbers, okay? Then we leave a place and we multiply the second number with all these numbers. Then we leave another place and multiply this number with all these numbers, okay? So now at the end, we add all these. So this here is the simple addition we learned before. Okay, what is the division of binary number? How binary numbers are divided? Okay, Gumam, for division, I will leave it to the next lecture, okay? Until you get expertise in addition, subtraction, and multiplication, okay?
Okay, yes.
Okay. Okay, so there's another topic. What is the ones complement? How the ones complement is done. Have you ever read about ones complement?
No, miss. I haven't heard.
Okay. So no problem. One's complement is actually the opposite, the negative of an so the opposite of a number. So in when we take one's complement of any binary number, if I give you any binary number, suppose it's 10101100011, it's a series of one and zeros, and I ask you, Gumam, take a one's complement of it. How will you do it? You will toggle all bits. You will replace all ones by zero and all zeros by one.
Zeros by one.
Okay. So yes. You see here is 110011. So what to do? Toggle all bits. Change one with zero. 1 0. Replace one with zero. 0 with one. So 11001 has a ones complement as 00110. Okay. This is very easy, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay. How we take two's complement? It is similar as one's complement, but there is just one more thing. What is that one more thing? That is, I just add one, the digit, another digit, one in the one's complement. Suppose I have to take the one's complement of this number, 11001. I will take the one's complement, 00110, and now I will add one. One in this. I will add one in this. So 1 + 0 is 11100. Okay.
Yes.
See here. 0110. So its one's complement is 10001.
001.
And now I will add one in it. Okay. So 1 + 1 is 0. Oh. 1 carry. 1 + 0 is 1001. So this is its two's complement. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, this is the I thought we will together do the quick quiz, but you can do it later. Okay.
Right.
One's complement, one you can find the one complement. Oh, I forgot. I actually had to write two here. So this was actually all today. I thought we could have done it in a better way by practicing, but since the practice is not possible today as you are out, so we leave it for your assignments. Okay.
All right. Miss, can you WhatsApp me this specific page so that I can do it and so recently back to you?
And the specific page of assignments?
Yes, miss.
Okay. I will. This I am going to send you this quick quiz. Okay.
Okay, miss.
And the multiplication and addition questions, few I had. Okay, so I'm going to share it with you. Beta, please share if you have any question regarding this.
No, miss, it's okay.
Yeah, okay.
If I do have, I ask you once.
Okay, that's very good. So I hope you do understand all the things we have studied and read today.
Yes, miss.
Okay, that's very good. So okay, if you have any question, you can ask me, or if you need to learn more about it, we can. Actually, today's lecture was more about practicing, and inshallah you will practice it, inshallah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So Gumam beta, if you have any question, you can stay, otherwise you can leave the class.
Thank you so much, miss.
No problem. Have a